allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun, let us march on till victory is won.
Education is the most powerful weapon that you can use to change the world. Thank you, Nelson Mandela, for reminding us of that. Because being black in America should not be a death sentence. Greetings, Board President Tucker, to all of our East Orange Board of Education members, Mayor Green, Principal Stallings, Assistant Principal Santoro, parents, grandparents, guardians, families, district administrators, faculty, staff, PTO members, students, and guests. But most importantly, to our bold, bright, talented, energetic, dynamic, visionary, gifted, distinguished, admirable, competent, skillful, resilient, and capable shining stars of the STEM Academy Class of 2020. Congratulations on a job well done. Let the new adventures begin. You know, it's been an extremely tumultuous, frustrating, sad, and unprecedented year of uncertainty. In so many ways, I feel as though you were robbed of so many of your senior rites of passage privileges that we once took for granted, such as being taught by dynamic teachers face-to-face inside of the classrooms, up close and personal, shaking hands, getting and giving hugs to friends and caring staff members, senior prom, college signing, a real live graduation, college tours, senior trips, yearbook signings, award ceremonies, morning announcements, afternoon announcements, socializing with your friends at lunchtime and after school, and the list goes on and on and on. Yes, the coronavirus is strong, but so are you. Yeah, we may be in lockdown, but God is still opening doors. So don't you dare quit. Adjust your crowns and continue to unleash your greatness. For no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Thank you, parents, grandparents, teachers, administrators, school counselors, support staff, and the entire village for helping us prepare the class of 2020 for college, careers, and life in a high-performing school. Students, today you stand on the brink of a new chapter in your life. Take a moment and reflect on everything that you have achieved. Take advantage of the opportunities that come your way. And when there doesn't seem to be any opportunities, create your own. Be the vision of excellence that you know and that I know you are capable of being. When I first came to the East Orange School District 3.5 years ago, you were just 8th graders. And it's been a magnificent journey watching you grow and blossom into the amazing, productive young adults that you are now. About to receive your high school diplomas. And I expect you to continue to receive more diplomas and degrees in the future as you achieve your bachelor's degree, your master's degree, and your doctoral degree. You are all special and full of potential. It has been a joy and a pleasure and an honor working with you as your superintendent of schools, and we will all miss you. You are graduating today, although virtually, but still alive, because you have worked diligently, you have achieved success, and you are leaders. There is an internal compass in each and every one of you. And I urge you to listen to it. Follow that voice, that intuition, your passion, and always do what's right and responsible. Don't succumb to peer pressure because everyone who calls themselves your friend is not really your friend. If they can't build with you, they can't chill with you. To put it in a nutshell and to keep it real, as I begin to resume back to social distancing, I have to simply let you know that you and your destiny, your future, your success will ultimately be determined by you, by the choices that you make. You decide. So decide to make good, smart, wise choices. William Shakespeare stated, "We know what we are, but not what we may be." Don't let anyone dim your light simply because it's shining too bright in their face. Remember that you are the head and not the tail. Utilize your haters as your footstool. And declare boldly that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. For you can do all things if you put your mind and your effort towards it. Be the leaders that you want to see. Strive to your fullest capabilities and meet all of your challenges head on in the years ahead. And remember, do your best, be your best, because you are the best. Storm clouds may rise, strong winds may blow, but you, class of 2020, will continue to shine. continue to unleash your greatness. I love you, and there's nothing that you can do about it. Congratulations and best wishes for continued success, STEM Academy, class of 2020. The best is yet to come. Congratulations.
Hello to the class of 2020 at STEM Academy. This is Mayor Ted Green. I am very honored and excited to celebrate this very important day with all of you. A day I hope you will remember for the rest of your life. What you have experienced this year is by no means ordinary. In fact, by achieving your goals and your dreams under all these difficult circumstances makes you very special. It is my hope that you will always remember just how extraordinary you are. You should be proud of yourselves, not just because you have accomplished a great educational milestone, but because you did it during a public health crisis. And while our country is battling with a period of massive social unrest and injustice, and for that, the class of 2020 will forever be emerged, not just in my heart, but in the city of East Orange history. Your testimony will be a test for future classes in determination, perseverance, persistence, and your strength. All of you are an inspiration. This will not be your only obstacle in life, but because you made your way through this, I'm confident that you can make it through anything. I encourage you to remain resilient. In the face of adversity, keep making history. Keep pursuing your goals and your dreams. Keep making us proud of you. I would like to take the opportunity also to thank my good friend, our good friend, Principal Dr. Vincent Stallings, along with the faculty and staff, for giving you this virtual commencement to honor your special day here in the city of East Orange. Class of 2020, we are one city. We are one community. We have one goal, and that goal is progress. And all of you are part of that progress. I ask all of you to go out and show people that East Orange pride. Show us how great you are. And show the world you're from East Orange. May God bless you. May God bless your families. And may God bless East Orange. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Greetings to the class of 2020 and the STEM administration. On behalf of the East Orange Board of Education, and as a proud mother of your friends, Sage and EJ McFadder-Davis, I would like to congratulate each of you on such an immense accomplishment. God uses the unexpected to create the unprecedented. As our world emerges from unprecedented times, we are in a new day. To the class of 2020, you are the genesis and the beginning for our tomorrow. And when I think of a gift of parting words and some of the things that I wanted to say to each of you, I want you to remember a few things as you go through life, as you're moving forward. Remember that trying times will define who you are in the midst of adversity. But the incredible and exciting reality is that each of you has an opportunity to create your own individual journey. So dare to dream. Dare to pursue the impossible. And as our country emerges from COVID-19 and protests across this country that we've never seen in our lifetime, remember that we embrace you, that we are here to support you. We encourage you and we believe in each of you. You each set the stage for the future. And by God's grace, the standard has been raised. By faith, your footsteps are ordered. And the destiny that was purposed for such a time as this awaits you with welcoming arms. My prayer is that you move forward with confidence and an inner peace. Remember, success is accomplished by overcoming. Your valley moments prepare you better than your mountaintop experiences. Welcome both with humility, but with the understanding that it's in those times that the strength of who you are is born, as your strength, endurance, and your faith will be tested and defined. The fact that you are graduating today should always be a reminder of the inner resolve that rests inside of each of you to succeed and become whatever you want to be in life. We are all so proud of you, and we're so grateful for the blessing of opportunity on the path that awaits you. You literally stand on the shoulders of giants that stood in your shoes with the same curiosity and wonder. Continue to allow your wings to soar and feel the presence of our love and our prayers. Allow it to lift you higher in the days ahead. May God bless each of you with humility, wisdom, perseverance, fortitude, prosperity, grace, protection, and a hunger for knowledge that will propel you into greatness. We love you beyond words, and to the graduating class of STEM 2020, move forward with this love in your hearts forever. God bless.
Students, good morning. It's a pleasure to celebrate your 2020 East Orange STEM Academy graduation with you. Although we are celebrating in a non-traditional virtual manner, it does not discount the hard work that you put in over the last 4 years to get you here. It does not discount the maturity, the perseverance that you displayed during the school closure for the last 3 months. You should be very proud of yourself. Over the next few months, students, you'll be facing many decisions, many difficult choices. You'll be meeting new people, and many of you will be living in new places. Make your choices wisely and lean on the guidance of those people who helped you get to this point. Congratulations on all your accomplishments. You have many more to come. My wish, students, is that all your hopes and dreams come true. Thank you for all your contributions to STEM Academy. You hold a unique place in history. The class of 2020 will never be forgotten.
To my East Orange STEM Academy senior class of 2020, congratulations on reaching this important milestone in your life. I commend you for staying the course and ensuring your 2020 graduation has become a reality, though your school year was cut short due to COVID-19. Unfortunately, the pandemic changed the world in an unprecedented manner. You made the best of a challenging situation and handled it with grace, dignity, and a level of maturity that was exemplary. As survivors of this global pandemic, unplanned remote learning, quarantine, and social distancing, you have learned invaluable lessons that will undoubtedly transform your development as young adults. I'm confident you'll be stronger for it. You inspire so many, including me, with passion, and steadfast determination to reach your dreams. Your future awaits you, and it is as bright as ever. As you step into the next chapter of your life, remember the 5 key ingredients for success. Number 1, belief. Continue to believe in your ability to achieve greatness. You are special beyond measure. Number 2, purpose. Recognize your why. You were brought into this world to do amazing things and to make great contributions to humanity. Number 3, determination. Don't let anyone stand in the way of your progress. You'll have haters, you'll have doubters, and obstacles in your life. Keep pushing, keep grinding. The only person that can stop you from reaching your dreams and your goals is you. Number 4, obligation. Remember, you have an obligation to those who struggled on your behalf. You have an obligation to those who sacrificed so hard for you. Many have paved the way for you, some known, some unknown. You stand on the shoulders of greatness. Number 5, vision. Because a person without vision has no direction. The Bible says, where there is no vision, the people perish. See yourself prospering before it even happens. Continue to dream big. Continue to think big. And watch how success will find you. Finally, as you navigate this, your future, always remember the village of East Orange that produced you. That is your foundation. That is your source of strength. Be proud of who you are. Be proud of where you come from. In your travels, carry yourself always in a dignified manner, in a respectful manner. Always conscious of your surroundings. And always remember the African proverb. It's not what they call me, it's what I answer to. I wish you peace, love, strength, and blessings as you embark on your new journey. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Greetings. This is Principal Kafele, and I want to congratulate, I want to commend, I want to salute, I want to applaud the senior class of East Orange STEM Academy on a job well done. Congratulations on your graduation. But I know this is not what you expected. For probably since first grade, maybe kindergarten, you imagined walking across a stage as a high school senior receiving your diploma and then moving on with your lives, whatever direction you're going, college, career, military, whatever it is. But here, this global pandemic came out of nowhere, and here we are. The world shifted. So you had to endure it. Your teachers had to endure it. Your administration had to endure it. The whole staff had to endure it. I had to endure it. But the good thing is, you got through it. The pandemic's still here. But you got through it. You made it to graduation, and I celebrate you for that. I want you to celebrate yourselves. Give yourselves a big round of applause because you deserve it. So now the challenge will be moving on, doing whatever it is you plan to do next year, but still trying to maneuver through this pandemic. But I know you'll be able to do that as well. But then we got a new challenge. May 25th, Memorial Day of this year. As you know, a young man by the name of George Floyd lost his life. He was murdered up in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And social unrest came out of that. First, all over America, and then all over the world. People are upset. I don't want to politicize your graduation at all, but I do want to say this. You are moving on. You're going out here into what people like to call the real world. I think the real world starts with birth, but people often say when you graduate from high school, now you're entering the real world, but it's been real ever since you've been on the planet. But as you're making this transition, I ask the question rhetorically, How will you use your voice? How will your voice play a role in the push toward change? How will you use it? Or how will you use your pen? What will you write? What will you post? How will you blog? What article will you write? What statement will you make? Or what will your presence speak when you're in the midst of others? Just your presence relative to who you are or a reflection of who you are inside. Who will you be? Because I'm saying that all of us have to find our lane, and then we have to find our voice. Because what one person's doing in this lane may not be for you to occupy the same lane. Your lane may be over here, or your lane may be over here. You've got to find your lane. Everybody's not a marcher. Everybody's not a protester. Everybody's not a demonstrator. Everyone's not a writer, right? You've got to find where's your strength? Where's your skill set best so that you can lend your voice to this movement? So as you make this transition out of high school, I just want you to think about that if you haven't been thinking about it. Because that which people out here in the world are fighting for, you're in this world with them. So I wouldn't want to see you victimized by any type of abuse. So therefore, you've got to make sure that you are in the game as opposed to being on the sidelines watching the game and then benefiting from others who were struggling within their lane. Like myself, I'm not a marcher. I used to be, but I'm not a marcher. I'm in a different lane doing things my way, on my terms. So think about that as you move on from high school. But I want to share this other thought with you. I want to share these words with you. This is not a long message, but I've been saying since, I guess around 1985, I developed these five key ingredients for success. And when I say success, I gave it a definition, had the audacity to define success according to how I see it. I said success is the ability to live one's own life on one's own terms. I repeat, success is the ability to live one's own life on one's own terms. So I'm saying to you, I want you to be able to live your life on your terms. In other words, you conceptualize what it is you want to do with your life, and then you do that. Of course, there's a process. There are goals that have to be set. There's a strategy that has to be written. And then you've got to implement the strategy. You've got to walk in the strategy. So whatever that is, that goal, that objective, that you see that this is what I want to do, and then you write out your plan, then you got to walk that plan. You got short-term goals. You got short-term planning toward the ultimate goal, the long-term goal of actualizing your goal. So here, you need these five ingredients in order to get there. Five words that you're very familiar with, but I put it in this context of achieving success. Word number one, belief. I'm saying you got to believe in you with everything you've got. I've been preaching this sermon ever since 1985. You've got to believe in yourself with everything you've got, even if no one else, including people who are close to you, if they don't believe in you, they don't believe in your dreams, so what? You must believe in yourself. You must believe in your dream. You must believe in the person in your mirror. Number two, purpose. Purpose is your why. Why are you here? Why do you exist? You got to be able to answer that question. What is that thing you want to do? What is your why? What is your reason? What is your because? What is your purpose? Just like a dictionary has words, every word has a definition. There's no word in the dictionary that does not have a definition and thereby a white space next to it. It has a definition, meaning it has meaning. Well, I'm saying your life has to have meaning, and your meaning is your purpose. Number three, obligation. I'm saying that the difference between your success or failure is non-negotiable. You must be a success story. You must be phenomenal. You must be extraordinary. There's no debate. There's no negotiation, because you have an obligation to be the best version of yourselves. Your responsibility. Number four, determination. And when I say determination, I'm talking about your drive. I'm talking about your ambition. I'm talking about your desire. I'm talking about your passion to get it done. Not someone else pushing you, pushing you, pushing you, pushing you, but you internally pushing yourself to achieve at high levels, to maximize your potential, to reach a level of self-actualization. You got to have that drive. You got to have that ambition. You got to have that determination. And then finally, number five, vision. You got to be able to see yourself in the driver's seat, in the pilot seat, right now in real time. See, the vision is where you're going to be. And I don't mean a dream. I mean a vision. You see this thing. You see yourself engaged in whatever this is that you said you want to do. So you got to have that vision, right? So you got to be able to see it within your mind's eye. Vision. So again, those five words: belief, purpose, obligation, determination, and vision. I want you to take those five words, embrace them, claim them, own them, right? Make them yours. And I promise you, if you do, you'll be in the winner's circle at some point celebrating your victory, because you let those words drive you to that point. So to the seniors again at East Star and STEM Academy, I just want to once again, lastly, finally, salute you, applaud you, commend you, and congratulations to you. You did it. You did it. You made it happen through a global pandemic and social unrest. You made it happen, and that deserves a big round of applause. So your parents, your family, your friends, they'll be applauding you for a long time because of your milestone. I wish you well.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you who don't know, my name is Adia Ali, the salutatorian of the East Orange STEM Academy Class of 2020. While I'd like to thank you all for coming, I will instead have to settle for thanking you for watching this video, and maybe even thank you for not skipping over my speech to get to the point for the student you came to graduate. So, you've made it through high school. Well, congratulations. Our lives up to this point are over. Grade school is a thing of the past. And now more than ever, your life is dependent on the choices you make for the future. This is the part in which I'm supposed to tell you what a long way we've come and what a journey it has been, which isn't much of an exaggeration. As students, many of us came in as the first middle school class 7 years ago, and not a single one of us is the same as we were back then. And the fact that many of us have been together for that long to seem further away than ever when it's the time to celebrate the end of an era is ironic at the very least. The most important reason that I bring up how long the senior class has been together, however, is because it stands as a symbol for everything we've gone through as a group. And though we've had hope along the way from our parents, teachers, as well as many others, it is important that we remember we've all managed to overcome any issues that has been thrown our way over the last few years. It's more important now than ever, when the world seems dark and uncertain, not only to cherish and celebrate the accomplishments reached, but also reflect on the obstacles that we've beaten along the way. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Wish you all the best in your future endeavors.
Good morning, students, parents, teachers, and staff. I would like to commence my speech by saying that it is both an honor and a privilege to be STEM Academy's valedictorian for the class of 2020. Despite being excited about this amazing news, I was extremely anxious. For the first time in my life, I can truly say that I have experienced writer's block. And I'm not talking about just winging an English essay, even if you started off having no idea what to write or what you were writing at the time. I spent days after I received the email racking my brain for the right words to say. Thankfully for me, we live in a digital age in which YouTube, one of the greatest apps, was bestowed upon us. Finding inspiration was just a search and a click away. I stumbled upon various videos of students giving their valedictorian speeches. I attempted to take note of what to do or what not to do, but I soon realized, in addition to receiving guidance from others, that the only way I could possibly be different was by making it my own. I can truly say I was not familiar with everyone in the class of 2020. This had a role to play in that I believe my speech would not be applicable to a majority, but perhaps the minority. Nevertheless, I think we could all come to a common agreement that one valuable lesson to take away from this year is to expect the unexpected, but persevere with good intentions. Never did I imagine that we would be the generation future students would read about in history books. There's no doubt that this pandemic has stripped us of the opportunity of enjoying our last year in high school. Although we had to give up one of the best parts, prom, we remained persistent and determined to graduate, even with the stress of switching to online learning. I may not know what the future holds, but what I do know is if we can continue our education in the midst of a pandemic, then our success truly lies within us. Usually people say to enjoy these 4 years of high school because it's supposed to be the best moment of your life. Well, I say enjoy every single day of your life because as the saying goes, you only live once, so make the most out of it. I hope the rest of our lives will be filled with plenty of congratulations, wealth, good health, and most importantly, happiness. Thank you to my family, those who made these 4 years a memorable one, and to all the amazing teachers. It's unfortunate that it took being in a pandemic for the world to realize the efforts that goes into molding and inspiring future leaders, but your hard work, consistency, and determination has not gone unnoticed. Finally, in the words of Barack Obama, we did not come to fear the future, we came here to shape it. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2020.
Good morning, class of 2020, teachers and faculty, family and friends. I am Alexandra Williams, and it is an honor to say I am one of the valedictorians of my senior class. I have been here at STEM Academy for the past 7 years as one of the first sixth graders to attend the school. I couldn't wait for high school to start back then, because it meant it was one step closer to college. In ninth grade, I remember talking to my history teacher, Mr. Weaver, and him saying these were going to be the quickest 4 years of my life. As any freshman would, I brushed it off, thinking it wasn't as fast as people kept saying it would be. It felt like it was dragging as slow as possible. But now that I rethink it, it feels like it was just yesterday I was in Miss Annunziata's 6th grade math class for first period, or sitting in Miss Clark Mayer's class reciting the motto, good, better, best, never let it rest until our good is better and our better is best. Even after 6 years, it is still ingrained in my brain. Or even struggling in AP Physics and AP Chemistry, staying after school for extra help and for too many retakes. College seemed so far away back then, and now I can finally say I'm here. Anxious because I'm leaving all I've ever known for a foreign environment. To leave my mother and sisters, my friends who I can proudly call family too, and teachers who I've become close with and who've become mentors to me. But I'm also excited to embark on this new journey, to continue my academic career, meet new people, and explore different cultures, topics, and places. Our college experience will be transformed due to the coronavirus, but I know we can make this experience our own, as these past couple of months have taught us resilience. For the past 12 or more years, personally it's been 15, we've been embarking on a journey to complete our education. We're supposed to continue that journey however we see fit, whether it is college, trade school, or job, etc. But we were all expecting a celebration for yet another milestone accomplished, just as we have with elementary and middle school, our high school graduation. As we sit behind computer screens, viewing our graduation from a monitor, I firmly believe the class of 2020 is going to get through this with the utmost strength, as the plans we have formed for weeks, months, perhaps even years, were taken away from us, we learned how to adapt. We no longer get to wear the suits and the fancy dresses for prom, and we no longer get to sit in our auditorium with the caps and gowns, as we see our best friends and classmates walk across the stage, while our family and friends make loud claps and whistles for us, despite being told to wait until the end. As I say this, I want to give a shout out to my mom, who has been the only one taking care of me since I was born, but can't celebrate the struggles we endured as we got here today. She is the reason I am in this position, because she taught me the significance of an education and was a great role model. As we continue into our first step into adulthood, I know the memories we created throughout high school will be held dear to us. This experience has taught us to hold the ones we love dear because we don't know when we will see them again. It has taught us how to adapt, how to come together as a community, and to take advantage of each opportunity presented to us, but not of the experiences we create. I can say East Orange STEM Academy was a place I've taken advantage of. I've gotten opportunities I am thankful for, but I've also talked to teachers and wish I had visited them more often. And I've talked to friends through FaceTime and wish I'd hugged them once again. STEM has provided me with people that I hope will stay with me for the rest of my life, and memories that I will keep with me whenever I feel nostalgic in college a couple of hours away, and for years down the line. I haven't gotten to know everyone, but I thank you, people of STEM Academy, for providing me with so many opportunities throughout my 7 years of wandering these halls. I hope I speak on behalf of all of us when I thank the families and faculty for supporting us throughout our journey, alongside friends for giving us endless amounts of laughter and motivation. Thank you for listening, and congratulations, Class of 2020.
Good morning, students, parents, guardians, Mayor Green, Superintendent Dr. West, Assistant Superintendents Ms. Champagne and Dr. Harvest, Principal Dr. Stallings, administrators, teachers, and fellow board members. It's an honor to stand before you as the president of the East Orange School District Board of Education. It continues to be a privilege for me to represent an educational system that stands for academic excellence. To the graduating class of 2020, you have successfully completed all of the requirements for graduation, based upon the approval of the faculty and the administration, and by the authority vested in me by the state of New Jersey and the Board of Education, I confer upon you your high school diploma with all honors, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Congratulations to the class of 2020. You may now turn your tassels. Thank you.
I'm Dr. Dawn Nickel Manning, President of the East Orange Education Association and East Orange STEM Academy Middle School Science Teacher. Congratulations to the class of 2020. You did it. You are the first and you are the best. We can remember you coming through the doors back in 2014 and making this a special place with the excitement and with the zeal in your eyes to be great at what you were expected to do. And you did it. And for that, we salute you. At this time, I ask that we clear our minds and our thoughts and that we give reverence to the Great One, our Heavenly Father, who has allowed for us to celebrate this day with you. Heavenly Father, we give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory. We thank you for each and every student that finished the course, that endured to the end. Despite tumultuous times dealing with the pandemic, they saw it, deemed it worthy enough to finish and to do the work. We pray that you would protect them, that you would keep them from all hurt, harm, and danger. Let no weapon that is formed against them prosper. Whatever they put their hands and their minds to do, we ask that you would anoint them, that it would go forth and do great things in the world. Bless their going in, bless their going out, bless them in the field, bless them in the city. We ask that you would use them in a mighty way, that you would pick people around them that will help them to shine and to do great and mighty things in the earth. We thank you for this opportunity, and we ask that you will continue to bless each and every student as they embrace and embark the things of this world. We ask this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And at this time, I would ask for anyone that is standing in the corridors of the world, if you would just move aside as we introduce to you the class of 2020 East Orange STEM Academy. God bless you.
STEM Academy graduates of 2020, in your travels, always remember the village that produced you. Always carry yourself in a dignified manner. Be well and be blessed.
Good morning. You were my first sixth grade class at STEM Academy. I called you my babies. Soon to become STEM scholars, and now the graduating class of 2020. I'm so very proud of you. I want you to follow your heart, continue with your dreams come true, be safe, be healthy. I love you.
Congratulations, class of 2020. It's Mrs. Maughan. It has been my honor to serve as your teacher. I wish you all the best in whatever future endeavors you pursue. And remember to hold fast to your dreams.
Hey, it's Mr. Witt here saying hello to the graduating class of 2020. I'd like to say congratulations to all of you. Thank you for all your hard work and best of luck in the future. Take care, guys.
Seniors, hey, it's Mrs. Porter here. I want to say to you guys that we've been together, many of us, for 7 whole years. We've celebrated a lot together. We've made it through some of your worst days together. We've made it and celebrated some of your best times together. CC the Turtle says, kindest regards and future endeavors. And I say, I'll miss you much. You're my adults now. Stay in touch, be well, be safe, make good decisions, and we'll see you soon. Good luck.
Congratulations to the class of 2020 from East Orange STEM Academy. We wish you all the best in the world.
Hi, seniors. First and foremost, I want to say congratulations on graduating high school. I'm so proud of you guys.
You guys hold a special place in my heart because I've known most of you since you were in sixth grade. I've watched you grow up from little immature sixth graders to now big, still immature seniors. Nah, I'm just playing with you. You know, I had to throw in Mrs. Rain also humor in here at some point. But once again, I just want to say congratulations. I know your senior year didn't turn out exactly how you would have wanted it to, and that's super unfortunate. So please make sure you guys come back and visit so I can give you your congratulatory hug like you deserve. Good luck in college. I know you're all going to do well. You're all going to succeed and go on to do bigger and better things. Congratulations once again. I'll see you guys soon.
Hi, this is Dr. Brown. I just wanted to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Go out, tell your story, impact lives, change the world.
Hello, class of 2020. This is Miss Annunziata. I just wanted to wish everyone congratulations. I'm so proud of you. Some of you I had back in elementary school. Some of you I had in sixth grade. You were the first sixth grade class of STEM Academy. And your sixth grade teachers, we all agreed that you guys were going to go somewhere in life. You were such a hardworking bunch, and we were always proud of you. We know we pushed you, but you never back down from anything we gave you. And that's what we know you're going to do as adults. Best of luck in life. And I can't wait to meet you again as adults. Mwah. Love you all.
Seniors, I just want to say congratulations on all of your accomplishments. I know it's been a bumpy year, but you guys pulled it through, and we're so very proud of you. Good luck on your next 4 years, and I can't wait to see what you guys do in the future. Congratulations.
Congratulations, STEM scholars, class of 2020. Make your book of life count.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. I've seen you grow from the sixth grade to the 12th grade. Each day has been a great day for me, knowing the leaders of today. I look to you for the action that I take locally as well as nationally. My message to you today is take action and take care. Congratulations, Dr. Jones.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I can't believe this day is finally here. I've had the pleasure of watching you all grow into the young adults you are today over the last 6 years. You are my first class at STEM, and I'll never forget some of the amazing memories we have shared together in and outside the art room. Each and every one of you are destined for greatness. As your class advisor, I couldn't have asked for a better class. You're tough, hardworking, smart, inventive, and I know you're all destined for greatness in your future. Congratulations, class. I hope you all know you have a special place in my heart, and I'm proud of each and every one of you.
Seniors, unbelievable how time flies by. I remember most of you as middle schoolers, and now you're here graduating high school. And like I've told some of you in class, you're going to blink once, and you're going to be ordering your cap and gown for your college graduation. These next couple of years, stay focused, stay the course, it will be worth it. And don't forget to stop by and say hello every now and then. We miss you guys very much. Love you all. And don't forget to do a little exercise while you're away at school. Take care.
20, congratulations. I am so proud of you. Anyone who knows me well knows that you all are an extra special class to me because many of you, we met when you were mere sixth graders. So I'm so grateful that I've had this opportunity to have a front row seat to your growth and development. And I'm happy that I had the opportunity to know many of your parents as well. So as you embark on your next leg of life, know that you will be sorely missed, but if you need help, you can always reach out. We're always here to help you. Congratulations again. God bless you.
Hello, graduates of STEM Academy. I'd like to take this moment to congratulate you on a job well done. During what has come to be a unique as well as historic time, we have weathered the storm and I trust come away from this wiser, stronger, balanced, and enlightened. Finally, remember to always be active, informed, involved, and vigilant. Godspeed.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm so proud of you. Now go out to the world and own it. Conquer it. It is yours.
Class of 2020, you did it. Congratulations.
Who would have thought the school year would end this way? Definitely not us. But despite everything you missed out on and all the hardships that have come your way, you guys made it happen, and I'm in awe of you. You would have been Mr. Owen's first graduating class, and I'm sure he'd be screaming louder than any of us. We're proud of you. So now it's time for you to go out there, change the world, shake it up, use your voice, and remember to make wise decisions. Love always, Miss Bracey.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I really do believe that you guys do have perfect vision. Get it? Corny joke. There you go. But on a serious note, I'm going to tell you guys something that I wish somebody told me when I graduated. A degree would never fail you. And this is coming from the heart. So from the bottom of my heart, please continue with this education process, with your educational career, because I know that you guys will amount to great things, amazing things. And don't forget to come back and visit. Don't forget where you came from, and don't forget how you got where you're going. Thank you. God bless. Congratulations again, guys.
Marie. Congratulations, seniors. This is Mrs. Willoughby, your math coach. I just wanted to say again, congratulations. This is your moment. This is your time. Go out and conquer the world. Good luck.
Hi, this is Daniel Jones from the New York Giants. Just want to say congratulations to the graduating class of 2020. You guys persevered through a global pandemic. Your hard work, your dedication does not go unnoticed. Congrats on all you've accomplished and all the best going forward.
Hey everybody, it's Dexter Lawrence II with the New York Giants. I just want to say congratulations to the 2020 graduating class. I know you all are going to do big things and change the world one day. You know, let's just make it through this pandemic and stay strong. Go Giants!
Hey guys, this is Will Hernandez, guard for the New York Giants. I want to give a huge congratulations to class of 2020. You guys did it. Now it's time to take the next step in your life. Whatever it is you want to do in this world, go get it. Dreams come true, but remember, they only come true through the basis of hard work and dedication. I know you guys got this. Just want to congratulate everybody. And this is a very exciting time of your lives. You get to start a new chapter. Take advantage of it. And go Big Blue.
Hey, class of 2020. It's Dalvin Tomlinson, defensive tackle with the New York Giants. I just want to say congratulations on your graduation. And one piece of advice I want to give you is stay confident in your pursuit of your dreams, because there's going to be a lot of ups and downs in your long journey. So stay confident, and congratulations once again.